All right, what's up, Zay Squad? We are back again with another video, and this is Vlogmas Day 6.
Stopped thinking like a victim. This time I throw it back. Boy, can you handle that? Got you tripping, gave you no attention. That's when I figured out.
So today, I'm going to be telling you guys about the first fight that I ever got into when I was in elementary school. But before we get right into it, I want to give a shout out to my friend Quasia. Yeah, that's about it. I'll make sure you guys follow her Instagram and Snapchat. I'll put that in the description. She asked me to do that this morning. So here you go, Quay. I love you. Now let's get right into it. All right. So this happened when I was in the fourth grade, right? Okay. So I'm not sure what month or this was, but I do know that it was unexpected. And for those of you who know me, you know that I am not a fighter. So I don't like to put myself in situations where I have to fight somebody. I'd rather talk it out with you. I know that's kind of lame, but you know, that's how I am. So let's start. So this was in fourth grade, and me and the guy who started it, we always had, like, beef or whatever. Since, like, the first day of school or whatever. And so, he didn't like me. I didn't like him and stuff. And so then just, like, every day it was just a nonstop back and forth thing that kind of got really old. And I was really tired of it or whatever. But I know I didn't start it, but I think he thinks I did. So one day, one day, we had just came from the library, and we were walking in a line, and I believe I was right behind them, and so the library and the cafeteria are, like, pretty much in the same place. There's a cafeteria, and then there's a door, and then behind that door is the library, and so we were coming from that. And then as fourth graders, we always stop to the bathroom. Every time we go past the bathroom, we always stop there. And then one of the lunch ladies had said to the kid, I'm not gonna say his name, he said to the kid, blah blah blah, I heard something that happened very well, right? And so I happened to hear it. And so then I answer with a congratulations. But I didn't say like that, I was like, congratulations. That's exactly how I said it. And I wasn't trying to mean anything, I was just saying it because, like, I didn't like you. But I was still, like, happy, glad for you, whatever. But I guess they didn't see it that way. So I walk inside the bathroom, and here they go right behind me saying, like, what did you say? What did you say? And I was like, congratulations. And then I don't know what happened after that. It was like something, I guess, went off. Because then another kid had came inside the bathroom, and I guess they tagged him or whatever, and they just came right at me. And I was like, what? And so like, I was just standing there for like a few minutes, like, acting like nothing had ever happened. And so I had just, like, I was like, forget it. And then I left. And then, I had said, I'm not proud of what I said. When I had left the bathroom, I had said something. I'm not proud of what I said. So I'm not gonna repeat what I said, but let you know it was not very good. And I had walked out of the building itself, cause like there's like a pathway from the cafeteria back to where our classroom was. And so we had walked out there because that's where our class was, just standing in line waiting for everybody to get out of the bathroom. And that was wrong. And then he comes out, the same person who started it, he comes out and said, what'd you say? He was like, what'd you say again? What'd you say? And me, the good Christian child that I am, did not want to get inside another fight. But this wasn't like a huge breakout fight. This was just like, it wasn't small, but it wasn't big either. It was just between like three people. And it didn't really cause any attention. So then I walk out and I was like, he was like, what'd you say? And I was like, I didn't say nothing. And then he was like, okay. So that was like the weirdest day for me, because I've never really gotten into a fight before, and somebody who's like that, who never liked me in the first place, who just started the fight out of nowhere, kind of got me like, what do I do? I don't know how to fight back, because I never fought anybody before. I wasn't raised to fight people. I was raised to, like, say your prayers, talk it out, go for God and say something about it, talk to your parents, talk to other people and stuff like that. So I didn't grow up in, like, the place where you had to, like, fight it out. So I believe violence is never the answer. Sometimes you just have to use your words. And that may seem like, that may seem lame or not as cool as fighting could be. But then after that, I had went home. I believe my brother found out that day too. And so then he told my parents, and then they had called me, and then we talked about it. And then the next day, it was like, they went to the vice principal and stuff like that. Something happened. And then, but that was like, I believe it was either early first semester or late second semester. No, late first semester or early second semester. Because, like, by the end of that year in fourth grade, we was all cool or whatever. I was like, I had talked to him, and I was like, why do you not like me? Because I've never done anything to you. And he was like, it was just like, he said, it was weird. He said, like, on the first day of school when I saw you, like, the way you was dressed, I did not like you. I was like, how did I dress? Because I came like a blue shirt and shorts. How old was I? Fourth grade? Wait, so kindergarten was 5, turning 6. First grade, 6, turning 7. Second grade, 7, turning 8. Third grade, 8, turning 9. I was either 9 or 10 years old. Actually, I was 9, because this was August when we went to the open house thing. And so he said, like, I never liked you. I was like, really, that's it? Like, that's not a good excuse. But so, yeah, that was it. I had a lot of backlash in fourth grade. That was, like, one of the worst years. And, like, I remember, like, something had happened, and, like, everybody was just, like, that was supposedly a friend, all had, like, escaped or ran away or something like that. But there's always that one person who would always stay, and I know exactly who she was. Her name was Michelle. I can't remember her last name, and I don't know where she is or how she's doing right now, but I know I will always remember that because she's the one who stood by me throughout everything. And so then by the end of that year, we cleared everything up. Everything was good and all. And after the fourth grade year, I had moved schools. So this was in Greenville. And so I had moved schools all the way to Woodson from fifth to eighth grade. So then my eighth grade year, when I was at the school, I was still living here. So then I had taken driver's ed that December. And so in my driver's ed class, there he was. So we didn't talk. We didn't say any words or whatever. We just looked at each other and stuff like that. He was like, because I remember him, because I remember everybody who, like, I know what you look like. I know you. And he didn't say anything, but I'm pretty sure he does remember me. But, like, we are all good now. Nothing bad has happened. We haven't spoken in years or whatever. But if you guys, but yeah, that was just the story. But, like, what I want to say is if you guys ever get into a fight situation, don't just, like, expect it to end in another fight. Use, like, talk it out first. And if that doesn't seem to go the right way, then you fight. But always talk first. And if that doesn't work, then you fight. Never fight first and then talk. You talk and then fight and then you talk again. And if that second time doesn't work, then you go all out. But I don't care how you do it, just do it. You get it over with. But it's over. So yeah, that's my story. If you guys like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. We are at 61 subscribers. Thank you guys so much. Let us get to 100 by the end of December. Praying that we do. And I'll come back at you tomorrow. Probably with, tomorrow. I'll come back at you tomorrow with a video. I'm not sure what I'm doing yet, but that will be Vlogmas Day 7, obviously. So this is the end of Vlogmas Day 6. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time. Also, shout out to Samantha, because she's been wanting me to do, like, a Vlogmas on, like, a day in the life of her. But I kept saying no. But I'm going to put in, like, the little video that she took today in class. So, Samantha, if you're watching this, I got you, girl. I'm going to do your vlog one day. I'm going to do it one day. It may not be this month. It may be this month. We never know. But I'm going to upload your video in here. So I hope you guys enjoy that. I'll put down her socials down below so you guys can follow her. And all right.
Samantha. Oh my gosh. I don't want to do chest crunches. Because I don't know how to do it. So. Look at chili. Oh my gosh. Samantha, please.
Not great about it.